The performer who is deeply moved and who without a shadow of embarrassment can openly groove to what is warmest and most human in man's psyche, behooved in a sense exhibits himself in a state of vibrant sympathy before the glazed stare of a large and heterogeneous crowd of the audience. Facing them, it makes sense that the performer who really communicates with an audience usually wins the loudest applause. Whether the truly potent ways of engendering legitimate excitement in an audience is for the player or singer to give the impression that chances are being taken to create this excitement, there really must be a precarious element present. There must be danger. Danger that the performance will get out of hand. That the performer, no matter how phenomenal his virtuosity may be, has set himself a task that is possibly beyond even his capability of realizing it. It's a thrill, you see. Nothing is so boring as a merely well-rehearsed performance. It gets booze, it's cursed. Nothing is so boring as merely well-rehearsed performance. It gets booze and it's cursed. Nothing is so boring as merely well-rehearsed performance. It gets booze and it is cursed.
Crumbling. You have to walk out in the middle of the street to get anywhere fast, especially when it's snowy and icy, like winter last. November expands and gets out of anyone's hands. No November expands, it gets out of anyone's hands. Ah, no, 'tis nothing new. The sufferings we all share have made me wild. He only struck and cursed me as he passed, and now he appears me to be just a child. In his intellect, can you see it? Can you inspect the seed of misgovernance in his soul? He can't control himself, but he continues to roll. Enter, sensing suddenly, what bitch is here? She shrinks back and shrieks and covers her face. Bitch is here? Nay, come hither, hide not your face. It is fair. Why your face is no disgrace. In fact, it's something at which I love to stare. Then whose inarticulate words went up the bedroom stairs? Release from the meanness of mankind and all worldly cares. The awful thing you conceive is something that is no longer hidden up your sleeve. Fell from my lips the name of the ships that wanted to cover the inner sea. Why, yesternight you dared to look at the brink of a new carved up city. Sickness and illness that turn the page.
I want everyone to pray, and then I want you to go home and think about it.
Think about it and the Boy Scout salute. I could come down with a parachute and scout food, and it would be so destitute. I know nothing like the things you salute.
You put it off again and again.